always serving a fresh cup of daily inspiration, Dianna Hobbs.
Today's inspiration is to let you know God is going to make you prosperous. Oh, if you've been feeling like you are overlooked and that God doesn't have a plan for your life, He has awesome things in store. Welcome to your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast. My name is Dianna Hobbs. I'm founder of Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, a 501c3 nonprofit organization. We distribute resources that are absolutely free all around the world just to help you grow in your faith and become everything God has preordained you to be. It is a blessing to have you here. I'm coming to you live from Empowering Everyday Women Ministry Studios in the city of Buffalo, New York. I was a little goofy in the studio this morning. I don't know why I have been so clumsy. I had some tea prepared for me, some good old tea with honey, and I knocked it over. I don't know how I did that. And then I reached over to grab the cup and knocked something else over. So we had a bit of a cleanup job to do in the studio this morning. But I am here. I'm blessed that you have joined me. I just believe every single time you press play on a podcast, you make the devil mad because he doesn't want you to be enriched and empowered. And so I just love it that you keep coming back and getting what you need for your soul. And the wonderful thing is, after you hear a podcast, every single one is available to you as a free resource. So you can stream it, download it on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher.com, at DiannaHobbs.com, even under my YouTube channel, under Dianna Hobbs. That's DiannaHobbs. Just click that red subscribe button and turn on your notifications. Hit that notification bell, and every time a podcast is uploaded, conveniently, you'll be among the first to know. I know you're busy and you're juggling so many things, and getting those notifications is great so that you can get your soul food, right? I'm so ready to get into what the Lord has for us today. So let's begin with a prayer. God, our Father, we love you. We thank you. You are awesome. You are worthy. Beside you, there is none other. Thank you for the individual that you have brought to this podcast. You drew them here to hear this word. And I appreciate you today. God, minister to them richly. Alter their mentality and their circumstances after they receive this fresh deposit of your word into their spirit. Allow it to bring forth fruit, and we will give you glory for manifestation. In Jesus' name, amen. My husband Kenya had to go on a one-day business trip the other day. And that morning, I was tasked with driving him to the airport. And since it has been frigid in Buffalo, with the wind chill dipping as low as negative 20, isn't that crazy? I bundled up. I put on a hat and a hood to cover my ears. I braced myself for the burning cold that stings my cheeks when I head outdoors. Buffalo has a special kind of bitter, mean cold. It feels like wrath. When the temperature drops, the air is brutally icy. I had to prepare my mind to step out into our version of the North Pole early in the morning. Kenya laughed at me because you could hardly see my face. I was not playing that morning. So when I stepped outside, my body reflexively tensed up. Then I noticed something. I was confused but pleasantly surprised because it wasn't even as chilly as I expected. I hadn't checked the forecast. I think I just assumed it would be a blustery and freezing day, as it had been for the past several days. It got so cold, they closed schools in Buffalo. Not because the snow was too deep, but because the temperature was too low. It was dangerous for children to be standing out on the bus stop. That's how devastating the cold was. But overnight, the temperature elevated, so I didn't actually need all those layers. I was feeling a little warm, so I didn't wear my heavy overcoat so I wouldn't overheat. It was so strange, though, that just like that, the weather changed. Today, in fact, here in Buffalo, in January, get this, the high is going to be 52 degrees. I mean, this is random. This out of the blue warm up makes it feel like spring outside, and suddenly everything is different. It doesn't matter what the actual season is, the atmosphere has shifted, and nothing feels the same today. You know, I was thinking, we grow accustomed to predictability, right? In my mind, it's January in Buffalo, and that means freezing cold temperatures, lake effect snow, and whiteout conditions caused by blizzards. But nope, it's nothing like that. Which reminds me, as it is in the natural, so it is in the spiritual. We cannot predict circumstances. We aren't in control of that. God is. The Lord is reminding you that it doesn't matter that you've been going through a winter season in your life where nothing is blossoming. Figuratively speaking, in the winter time, the atmosphere and conditions are uncomfortable, right? The ground is not suitable for growth. You're not flourishing and thriving in winter. There are no leaves on the tree. The land is barren. But God sent this word to let you know He is going to show off and flex His power and shift the circumstances in this season, in your winter. The Lord of hosts is reminding you that He is in control of the outcome. Do you think that God, that commands nature to behave a certain way, isn't in command of your situation and mine? He is always in control. Today, He's letting you know He's changing the environment and atmosphere and outcome in your life. So what that it looks like winter? You will still live in abundance. So what? You're going through a dry place. You'll be prosperous. So what? You've been enduring affliction. You will be fruitful. Hey, if God did it for Joseph, He will do it for you. Think about Genesis 41. After Joseph interpreted Pharaoh's dreams for him, God gave him favor with the king, and Joseph was made ruler over all Egypt, second in command to Pharaoh. After all he had been through, being sold into slavery, falsely accused, and locked up, God still prospered him in hostile territory. Now, the Bible says Pharaoh gave Joseph a new Egyptian name, Zaphnath-Paneah, and also gave him a wife whose name was Asenath. She was the daughter of Potipharah, priest of On, and the couple had two sons. I love how in scripture names had meaning, and the meaning of Joseph's sons' names are fascinating. Now stay with me. His older son was named Manasseh. He named his son Manasseh because Joseph said, God has made me forget all my troubles and everyone in my father's family. And you remember his family. They put him through. They hated Joseph. His brothers were jealous of him because he was favored. But God blessed Joseph so richly, he said that he forgot all about the troubles of his past. God is able to bless you to the degree that the hurts and struggles you've been through will become a distant memory. You won't even be thinking about what the enemy put you through because you'll be too busy counting your blessings. God's going to bless you just like that. But God did not stop there. He blessed Joseph with yet another son. And this son's name was Ephraim. And Joseph named him that because he said, God has made me fruitful in the land of my affliction. Isn't that awesome? That's just so rich. I love the word of God. Somebody listening to me is headed to Ephraim, where God will make you fruitful in the land of your affliction. He is going to cause your seed to blossom and bring forth fruit right in the middle of winter time. He knows all you've been through. You've been overlooked, mistreated, dismissed, disregarded. You've struggled, cried, prayed, and been confused about what God was even up to. Life for you, like Joseph, hasn't been fair. You've endured injustices and dealt with consequences of things that weren't even your fault. But now God is rewarding you. He's going to set you on display as evidence of the favor that's on your life. It's been a hard road, I know. Sometimes you've wanted to give up. You didn't see how God was going to bring you out or how He was going to do what He said He would and favor you. Oh, but this word is confirmation that He's making you fruitful. You're going to be prosperous. Forget what's behind you. There is better up ahead of you. Get ready to possess what He has for you. The tears were not in vain. The pain was not in vain. The heartache was not in vain. The loss was not in vain. God has not forgotten you. He has not forsaken you. He has not overlooked you. He has not turned His back on you. His word over your life has not expired. You are going to be fruitful. You just got to prepare for it. To get this word in your spirit, I'm simply stirring the words Joseph said into your cup of inspiration from that 41st chapter of Genesis that we've gone over. And it says again, God has made me fruitful in the land of my affliction. That's about to be your testimony. As you drink down the contents of your cup, expect to go through a life evolution. Expect to feel that sense of amazing grace where I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. I was in lack, but now I'm prosperous. God is revolutionizing your world. Who is this word for today? He's making you prosperous for His glory. He's giving you beauty for ashes, joy for mourning, and the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, according to Isaiah 61:3. I feel myself getting happy in the studio. He's flipping things in your favor. All that adversity the adversary sent did nothing to stop the flow of favor in your life. Get ready for an overflow of blessings. God is making you prosperous. A series of blessings, one right after another, is about to hit your house. It must happen because the fullness of time has come for your breakthrough. Like Joseph, God is raising you up. He's going to make you fruitful, both spiritually and naturally. You will thrive in the areas He has called you to so that you can fulfill the great work of the kingdom in the earth. You are headed to Ephraim, where you will be fruitful in your land of affliction. Get ready. Now let's pray. God, I pray for this, my sister, this, my brother, this, your precious servant. God, I thank you that you're informing them that their season of release is here. I rebuke discouragement, Satan. I rebuke you and your lies and how you have tried to deceive them into believing that God has forgotten them and that His word has expired over their lives. God, we thank you for manifestation. We thank you that they will bring forth much fruit and they will do it all for your glory. And for all these things, we thank you. We believe it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Your Daily Cup of Inspiration podcast has been brought to you by Empowering Everyday Women Ministries, where we help fuel your faith every day. For more information, log on to www.deannahobbs.com.